Operational report. Submarine detections. Crash. Kubera leaking. Repairs complete. Ah, crap. Jeez. Couldn't. Of course, there's going to be a collision. Detections. 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 Kill credit. Flooding. Repairs complete. Expansions. The bases have maximized, I think. Upgrades to the headquarters. Reinforcements. San Francisco, Pearl Harbor, and Singapore. All those divisions. Look at that. One, two, three, four, five, six divisions. Seven. And one, and an armor division. There was a collision, so first priority, always get to the collision. Oh, for the love of God. Okay, we've got two damaged ships here. There's only 27 ships, for the love of God. How the... I swear to... If there was only one... If there were two ships in a task force, the AI would conveniently find a way to crash them, because that happened. That really did happen. Stupid. Okay, just means another... These amphibious vessels are lost to the attack. Now, if you can crash 27 ships together, how the hell are we going to get an invasion group up with consisting of thousands, a thousand ships? Probably a thousand ships. Stupid. All right, there's no way to avoid it either. No way. We can try to minimize it by having smaller units, but other than that, you can actually get rid of it. Some players have suggested that you can try to minimize it by having better captains. No one's ever proven it one way or the other, I don't think. Now we're checking submarines. Cabrilla, still one knot at a time. It was 11. Now it's 10. Okay. She's still creeping back. Haro is not doing much better at two knots. Good grief. This is Blenny. Blenny's heading for Manila. No. Oh, actually, we're here. We're in the north. We might as well go for Nago. A lot of subs are in Manila, in Naha. So let's give the business to Nago. Checking others. This is Haddock. Again, why go all the way to Manila? We're at 5 knots. Let's drop in here, spend a few days, see the sights, repair, and then we can get the hell out of here. We got 329. Muscalunga. Gosh, these guys are brave. Sometimes you just wish they weren't that brave. Just come home. When you're hit, it's okay. Come home. We've checked for damage. Now let's make sure about the endurance. These guys are, all heading back to refuel and rearm. That's good. Nago, we still have everybody trying to repair. Nothing doing. We've got a hawkbill trying to come out. Naha. Trying to repair. And Manila. Oh, hey, we got a number of fleet boat back. Good, good. 2, 4, 6, 7, ready to go. We're gonna rearm and refuel. Not bad. Okay, so we have 6, 2, 4, 6, 7. We're gonna put a couple into each location and 3 into Shikoku Station. Checking the commanders, making sure that we actually have some good... Yep, decent commanders in all of them. Nice to see. Only 13 boats remain in repair, and a lot of them are going to come out. Only two long-term, really two long-term 5 and 10. We're quiet on Singapore and Borneo. Empty in Legazpi. Only one transport group has arrived. We're going to refuel from at sea and disband it. Oh, one other carrier group has arrived too. It gets a little bit of dings here, so we'll disband it for repairs. The tankers are pretty darn good, pretty darn close to empty, so we're going to form them up and get rid of them. The last group of AOs finally makes it into the... Hold on. These are empty already. What the hell? What a screw up. I thought they were... I misread the column, and I thought they were full last time, so I didn't send them home. Stupid! All right, we're sending the tankers back, all according to their own speed. What a waste of clicks. Then when these guys are done, they'll break off, and again, because the AI, we have to mix up three different speeds on the same freaking group. So we're going to be crippled by this idiot down here. The only good thing is, this is the last tanker group. We finally... Apari, we have our heavy bombers. Let's take a look. You know, these... with a fatigue level of 1, last time I ordered them to attack, they didn't attack until the next turn. So... let them go? No, let's go for it. All the super forts, let's go after Nagasaki. That means we have to make sure these guys up here recon. Retired, okay. Oh, these guys flew it, and they didn't collect any fatigue. Well, we may not have collected much fatigue to notice, because we have 83 pilots here. This is where we stashed all these spare pilots. Every single pilot that's in the recon pool is sitting in this plane. So they don't fly a hell of a lot, but they were training. And once they got up to the level 50 training, they just stopped training. They just didn't get any more experience. So I've just left them here. And the ones that fly, that will fly. The ones that don't, hopefully they'll choose someone that doesn't need help. Okay, he's going long range. It's normal range is 11, so we want to make sure he has a chance. We want to give him the drop tanks. Even though it might burn more supply, it'll still put him in minimum radius so that we don't have to... the fatigue will be lower for this, okay? So these guys are flying. Over at Baton Island, we fought our way into it. The Thunderbolts did okay. Did okay. Now it's time to fight our way out. Now it's time to pull out. The damaged ones are staying behind. I'm going to pull these guys back. We're going to make a quick transfer. Yeah, good pilots, just damaged aircraft. So I'm going to go back to Apari. We're just going to rest, let him recover, and maybe we'll come back. But the Thunderbolts are doing okay. We're keeping it under 100, under 150. The Hellcats are fighting the low battle. Two at 5,000 and one at 10,000, and the Thunderbolts are coming at 10,000 and 15,000. Naha, the transport was attacked again, so she better dock. Naga was okay. We're going to check, harvest the pilots. We're quiet on Iwo Jima and Hahajima. Well, the usual raids. Over at Pagan. Okay, the Corsairs are holding it. Let's see, check on Peleliu. This is the relief. They're down to a 1. You know, with a 1, we probably aren't going to get much better than that, because it just means that there's too many pilots on the island, too many planes on the island. Let's see, can we get it all the way up to Pagan? Pagan! Don't crash, crash! Did we kill one? No, looks like we left, or we might have left one behind. Okay. So all our job is just to fly around in circles. Let's do it. Let's just fly around in circles. Yeah, we left. No, we didn't crash. I don't think we crashed any. Here's two here, and we did crash and kill one. Fudgy. Fudge. We don't get any more replacements, so we'll only have one in reserve, but that should be enough. That should be enough. Damn Canadians. All they know how to do is play hockey. Okay, I'm making sure all the ships have turned around. No, we don't need it anymore. Return to Manila. Manila Gorilla. Ah, I missed it last turn. I don't know. I don't know if I missed it last turn. I had to make sure, but yeah, all these guys head on back. We don't need any additional retrieval. They're all picked up. That's all we got. No enemy units detected in the area. The AOs have unloaded at Pagan and are now heading back to Lihu to pick up more. The cruisers are, we're going to put up a one zone, a zero range hex. We're going to put them on patrol right above the hex. Why? Because these ships, even though they're good, the experience is good on these guys. We can always get a, we can always try to get a little bit more. These guys, I mean, they're excellent experience day and night. While these guys don't can get a little bit more, the only way to get it is to train. Now we don't have to worry about fuel because these little AOs that just keep or we'll just keep bringing it in, and it doesn't cost very much. At 100,000, 200,000, we got plenty of fuel. We can always run down here to grab more at Guam or Tinian. I mean, any of these guys have got fuel, extra fuel, so we may as well train the crews while we have them. And I'll put another surface action group here. Well, we'll train the gunboats as well, the patrol corvettes. I don't have any other use for them. I could send them on to Manila. Yeah, I could, but I'm not going to bother. The by having them out, the crews, see, we get no replacements for these damn things. The recon planes continue to fly as well, so they get more experience just flying regular missions. The little transport group, like island freighters, I'll call these, along with the AKV air transport unit, they've arrived at Lihue. We're just going to load up with supplies and send them back out to Iniwetok. With another 18,000 on there, I think we can leave Iniwetok alone for the rest of the war. And this one's coming back damaged. Iniwetok. Okay, the Catalinas are repaired. Let's go. How far can we go? Can we get to Manila? Please tell me we can get to Manila. Are you freaking kidding me? Are you that crappy you can't get out of here? All right. Oh man, we're really overloading Peleliu. You know, if we're gonna overload Peleliu, let's go. Our range is a 43. Okay, so let's go. If we gotta go, let's go Guam. Let's stop off in Guam and transfer. Guam, next time we'll fly over to. Hold on. Oh man. Did I just. I just flew the Mariners over there. Oh, for the love of God! I can't believe how stupid this is. Flew the wrong squadron! Jesus. So, guess what? I gotta fly them back here next turn. Jeez. Yeah, and I'm sure this happens all the time in war. All the time. Okay, we were the it was the it was these guys, I think. It was the Catalina Fives. These guys have great range. Let's just rest them. San Francisco, the divisions have arrived. Excellent. Let's take a look at them. We are, oh man. Are you freaking kidding me? 1941 squads? Are you freaking kidding me? What to do? We check the squads, and there's only 254 in the inventory right now. We're building 80 per month, so that's two per day, maybe two and a half a day. So at two and a half a day, we need three over 300 before we can start upgrading. So that's going to be what? Two and a half per day would make that almost what? 15 days? About 15 days before we can even start upgrading. So who wants to, are we going to stay around for that? Hell no. Hell no. How are the tanks coming? There aren't any tanks stockpiled. See, we're using them up as soon as they show up, they are taken as replacements. We don't have any stockpile on tanks. So for that reason, I'm going to order the units. We'll take replacements, but we're not going to upgrade. Normally I would just sit here and just let it upgrade, rest and upgrade the whole thing. But we don't have enough. We don't have 300 to upgrade this side. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop these guys into strategic. Oh, and we're also we're not going to make it in time for Kanoya. So what we're going to do is we're going to plan way, way, way the hell ahead. Let's plan for, do we need it for Shimonoseki? Let's try Shimonoseki. Sure. Let's try one for Shimonoseki. One for Hiroshima. It's not like when they're on ship, they don't gain any experience. They don't gain any planning points. So it's not like it makes a difference. During on the transit across, it's going to mean a whole hell of a lot of nothing. And I'll put another one for Hiroshima. Anyone else? Great. Now we've got, sorry. We have a couple of these guys here. Engineer regiments, right. Well, it's not a big deal. Let's plan ahead. I'll put Hiroshima and Hiroshima. We could put anything. These guys aren't going into combat, so it doesn't really matter. I just don't want something saying San Francisco on it. That's all. Nobody else? Okay. Now, we've got these guys going into strategic. We've got, just guess what? Transports arrived, baby! Right in time, isn't it? Isn't that? That's just not. I'd rather be lucky than good. So we're gonna disband these guys. They're both in. The question is, well, these guys are going to take a couple, 3 days to load. A couple of 3 days. Let's take a look and see how much lift we're going to need on these guys. We'll form up the transport, and I'm just going to grab one of the big babies, one of the big bastards, and I'm going to dock it. We're going to pretend load these troops. Well, hold on. Let's try 3, 2, 3, or even 4. That's fine. What we're going to do is we're going to pretend load. If we load the infantry, 1, 2, 3, right? Won't load any supplies or fuel, but let's just say we don't have enough. Fine, get more ships. Show us how much you need. 12 capacity still insufficient, so we could use more cargo capacity. So it looks like we're going to need the AKs. Why is it grabbing this stupid little XAKL? That's just dumb. Get more ships. Docks are full, no more room. Okay, let's go back. Let's do it a different way then. We want to find out how many it takes. So let's go back. Unload these. We'll load one unit at a time. Let's transfer all the extraneous ships back in there. Okay, you miserable turds. We'll go with one. West Point. We'll load. Right. Verify. Okay, tell me how many ships you need and get all of them. We're going to have a 10% safety factor and a 12% cargo safety factor. I don't like the cargo safety factor because that usually means that you're going to be waving bye-bye to your trucks. So let's go back. This is for the 2nd Infantry. So we're going to mark this 2nd Infantry. And we'll add one more transport to her. AK. Ooh, Clan MacDonald. Oh, I guess we can't even do that. Oh, crap. It's a 7600. Let's see. What's the smallest ship we can add on here? That's still fairly fast. I'll take a 6500. Oh, no. Yeah, I'm going to take a 6500 because it's still fairly swift. And it should be able to keep up. We should be able to sail with that. Okay. This one's done. Undock. So we'll form another transport. And we'll do this for the other two. Here's the disposition for the 44th Infantry, and we've got 17%, not good enough. Transfer, let's hope one more will do it. And we'll take another 6250. Is there another 65? Oh, it's a 6500 I have to add. Okay, that's the next one. We could also go explore. No, we'll go 6500 or 5700. What's your choice? Let's use the 6500, right? We don't want to be screwing around. Okay, so what were we loading there? I can't even remember. Was it the 4th Division? 44th. So this is 44th. We're going to do it one more time. Form. Transport. We want the big... Oh, the AI used up all the biggest ones. Wow. Okay, I'm concentrating on the fast bastards. Bedford. Let's look for Bedford. Load troops. And this one will go for 5th Infantry. Okay. Used up all the big ones. Okay, hold on. We could add another ship. So troop space is way the hell over. We have way more than we need. Let's take some of that back because we have to send excess capacity over to Hawaii. Okay, so we've gotten all three of these. I'm going to have to take screenshots of these. How else are you going to remember it, right? So in 3 days' time, or however many days' time, when they're ready, this is the component for, this is the pickup for 2nd, for 44th, and, oops, and, what? Oh, no, sorry, the last one's the 5th. 5th Infantry. Okay, so these are the ships that should be able to pick up everybody and go. All the excess capacity, we have there's still a couple of engineer regiments, and they're not really important. We can pick them up with regular transports. It's the troop transports which are important. Do we have any troop transports? Yes, these are the troop transports we have. And we're going to send all these extras. These are the fastest ones I could get. I will send all the transports over, load them up with supplies, and send them to Hawaii. These last few transports, I'll send maybe the Speedy 17 over. But other than that, the other ones are just going to stay here. We can load some of those construction regiments to go along. Instead of... those are the big troop transports. We really do got to send them over to Hawaii. Here, okay, here's the line up. Here's the line up. Anyone here and back can divert to Hawaii. Here, like this one. Let's divert this one to Hawaii. We've got lots of carrying capacity here. All the other ones are past Hawaii already. We could probably carry most of the division here. Same thing, these guys, this should be plenty to pick up at Hawaii. There's four divisions there, so we got to plan on lots. Here's another one. Yeah, you're going Hawaii. Enjoy the islands. If they mess up and they use there's too much capacity, that's fine. All we're gonna do is, here's another one, divert Hawaii. We'll pick up supplies at Hilo or Niihau. Okay, these guys will go back. I'm gonna send. It's a minor one. It's a minor, small guy. I could send them either way. Just solidarity. We're gonna go to Hawaii. We'll go to Hawaii. This should be way more than is needed. And it's probably way more than is needed over here too. I don't think I even need to send those transports. That's a lot of transport. That's a lot of lift. A lot of lift. With about 150 transports just at the tipping point heading down for Pearl Harbor, I'm not gonna muck around with that too much more. I'm just gonna take the ships here. Okay, we're gonna scrub that idea, disband, disband, disband. We're gonna repair these guys. We're just gonna take all the troop transports, load the hell out of everything, and just go from here. Let the returning ships take care of Pearl Harbor. Okay, we dropped everyone. Have a massive port like this, and we just turn everybody into critical for repairs. Everyone should be finished in one day. If we're lucky, it'll all finish in one day. So all these other ones are just gonna wait. We'll load tender. No, none to be loaded. Okay, everyone's refueled. Everyone's just waiting to go. Yeah, I'm priority's got to go to the divisions. So we're gonna wait. We're gonna let them load first, and then load anything else, any other junk afterwards that we want to send. So we got 2 days. We're gonna call a slight halt to the war just so that we can reload. Inbound, we still have a couple more. We have transports on outbound. No, this is outbound, but we have. Here's more transports coming in, troop transports, and another group of troop transports, which is up to our ears in troop transports. Lots of lift capability, lots of lift. So we're not going to have a problem lifting these guys. I There's already some transports heading down to Pearl Harbor, so these guys are going to help as well. So we're really not I'm not going to be too concerned about lift capability. I think we'll be just fine. A group of tankers or oilers have returned to Los Angeles. All damaged, we're going to repair, and while we repair, we might as well load them in dock. Okay, we're going to do this same thing for Pearl Harbor. We're just going to set it up. No need for any upgrades. Just get them packed and ready to go, as well as, oh, I don't know where the hell we're going to. Where are we going to land? We'll just pick one in the future. Hiroshi Spearfish fires two torpedoes at a tanker, gets a hit, she's gone. Sea Leopard launches two torpedoes at a tanker, miss. Menhaden fires two torpedoes at a transport, misses, but get hit by the escort. Razorback launches two torpedoes at a tanker, misses, and gets hammered by the escort. Lamprey launches two torpedoes. Both strike the tanker. She's gone. Aspro evades the patrol boat. Here. Oh, it went! It went! That ain't so good. Night attack on Baton Island, Tsurugi. Two are destroyed. Night attack on Hahajima. No interceptors? Aw, crap. Base got caught? Crap. Night attack on Nagasaki. Uh-oh, he's got aircraft in the air. Intercepting. One destroyed. Bomb. That's an E-boat only. All right. Second wave. Oh, man, this hurts. This is gonna hurt. Hajima bombed by night. The Hellcats interfere. Intercept. Nagasaki bombed. 10 more. We lose another one. Oh, crud. Did we wipe them all out already? Is that why we're not getting in ship? Oh, there goes the ship hit again. Yeah, this is going to be expensive for not all these little e-boats and crap. This is just worthless crap. I'm throwing away good pilots, good planes for stuff that don't matter. I was hoping to catch a destroyer or maybe that heavy cruiser if she had survived, but nothing. Hajima, under attack by piggies. The Hellcats finally show up. Nagasaki, under attack. We lose another super fortress, probably two. Your Sargo fires and sinks a transport near Kanoya. Moray fires a pair of torpedoes. Ah, hits a submarine. Good job. Capitain fires a pair of torpedoes at a patrol boat. Miss. Lamprey launches a full spread at a tanker. One hit. That's all we need. One hit. Barbaro fires a pair of torpedoes at a transport. Hit. Air Raid Singapore. 33 aircraft in. We shoot down 11. But we also... Holy cow, that's a lot. That's a pretty bad day for us. Afternoon air attack. Hajima under attack. 34 interceptors. We shoot down 3 Bettys. Hajima under attack again. 2 Nels are shot down. The task force at Nago under attack by Grace torpedo bombers. Whoa! 14 out of 21. That's a pretty good sweep there. The base at Naha under attack. 6 bombers. 2 are shot down. Given the damage on Hajima, this is not a good day. That's not pretty. Not pretty at all. Lots of bomber reinforcements arrive at Pearl Harbor.